In this video, I will cover shock. Shock is a serious medical condition that occurs when the body's organs and tissues do not receive an adequate supply of oxygenated blood. Shock can be caused by a variety of factors, including traumatic injury, severe infections, allergic reactions, heart attack or failure, and other medical conditions. Signs and symptoms of shock include shortness of breath, dizziness or confusion, rapid pulse, weakness, feeling cold, nausea, or thirst. Types of shock. Cardiogenic shock occurs when the heart cannot pump enough blood to meet the body's needs. It can be caused by a heart attack, severe heart failure, valvular dysfunction, ventricular or septal rupture, infections, pulmonary embolism, cardiac tamponade, and drugs. Cardiogenic shock has a high mortality of greater than 70%. Hypovolemic shock occurs when there is a significant loss of blood or fluid volume in the body, such as from bleeding, dehydration, or severe burns. The reduced blood volume leads to a decrease in blood pressure, which can cause organ damage and failure. Fluid volume compensatory mechanisms are activated during hypovolemic shock, which include the activation of the renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system, antidiuretic hormone secretion, and movement of interstitial fluid into the vascular system. Neurogenic shock results from the parasympathetic nervous system causing widespread vasodilation. The sympathetic nervous system is inhibited as well. Neurogenic shock occurs from nervous system trauma, depressive or anesthetic medications, severe pain, or emotional distress. The overactivation of the parasympathetic nervous system can also cause a slowing of the heart rate known as bradycardia. Anaphylactic shock is an immune system reaction to an allergen such as peanuts, shellfish, latex, and insect stings. The immune system produces large amounts of IgE antibodies that bind to mast cells and promote the release of inflammatory cytokines. This results in widespread vasodilation and increased vascular permeability, which inhibits movement of blood. Anaphylactic shock can occur rapidly, and death can occur within minutes if not treated. Treatment includes administration of epinephrine, adrenaline, antihistamines, steroids, vasopressors, beta-adrenergic agonist bronchodilator inhalers, and fluids. Septic shock results from an infection that enters the blood, bacteremia, and progresses to systemic inflammatory response syndrome, which is characterized by fever, increased heart and respiratory rates, and a high white blood cell count. Septic shock can be caused by pneumonia, abdominal and urinary tract infections, fungi, and viruses. The infection triggers the release of over 100 inflammatory mediators that promote inflammation. Obstructive shock occurs when there is a blockage in the blood flow, such as a pulmonary embolism or tension pneumothorax. The blockage prevents the blood from circulating properly, leading to organ damage and failure. I hope you've learned about shock. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.